Hello friend, welcome to the today's session. In today's session we'll be discussing one practical which is in our course, that is nothing but the Carnot cycle. It's a theoretical engine which was proposed by the French physicist in 1824, that was Carnot. The basic understanding of this engine, it consists of different parts which I have shown you for your references over here. The basic engine, the Carnot cycle, it is divided into four parts. These four parts are nothing but the working substance which is used in this type of cycle. It is the gas, okay? And this gas, it is going under the four different cycles. One is the isothermal expansion, another is the adiabatic expansion, then followed by isothermal compression and the adiabatic compression. So our understanding of this engine, what I have done over here is that I have shown a schematic of the some diagrams. Basic Carnot engine, it consists of a cylinder which is fitted with a piston, and this fitted piston, it can move up and down, and this this piston which is fitted, it is frictionless, means there is no friction between these two surfaces, this and this. Okay. In addition to this, this consists of a source which is maintained at a fixed temperature T1. Okay. The another, it is the sink which is maintained at a low temperature, which is T2. So in this case, T1 is always greater than T2, or T2 is at a lower temperature as compared to source. As we know that from the second law of thermodynamics, that heat can flow from higher temperature to lower temperature. This simple principle, it has been used in designing any kind of engine, because it can flow from high temperature to low temperature, and what amount of heat we can convert it into the work or mechanical work, that is nothing but that will be the efficiency of that particular engine. So in this Carnot cycle, Carnot has proposed this theoretical engine which was never came into the practice, but this engine, it was having it was defect free. What are the defects? It was present in the all the practical engines that was removed in this type of engine. This was the basis of the all the engines when it was in, from this stage onwards, all the engines were developed for that. So further, what we will consider in this figure, the surface which I have shown with this dark color, dark shaded black color, it is the it represents the conducting surface. And the surface which I have shown with the dash colors or with this marking, it is an insulating surface. So first of all, let us start. In this one, we will consider if working substance here in this case, it is a gas. Okay, so consider some amount of gas, it is filled in this cylinder, okay, which is fitted with a piston, which is a frictionless. Okay, because you don't have a friction between these two surfaces. Now, what happens, these different walls, these three walls of this cylinder, it is insulating in nature, and the lowermost surface, it is conducting in nature. So what we will consider, initially we will put this cylinder on this source which is maintained at a temperature T1. So what will happen when this assembly is kept on this source which is at a temperature T1? So this surface, it is conducting. So this surface is conducting. So the gas or working substance which is inside this cylinder, it will take out some amount of heat from this source. Okay, and when this heat is taken by this cylinder, when we are keeping this on this source, when this cylinder is kept on this source, it will take certain amount of heat from this one, and the working substance which is gas in this case, which is present inside this cylinder, it will expand. So we will have the first step, that is nothing but the isothermal expansion. In this case, we will get the isothermal expansion. Okay, so what isothermal expansion we will get, we will discuss that first. Okay, let us say initially the temperature pressure of the gas, it is P1, and volume of the gas, it is, let us say, V1. Okay, and let us say it is represented by a point C1. So it is the first operation, so let us say it is C1. So when I am giving a certain amount of heat from the source to this working substance, what happen as a result of that? It's as I'm giving the heat to this substance, and it is an isothermal process, means in this process temperature of the system is constant. Temperature is constant. In this case, temperature is constant. Okay, and as the temperature of this system is constant, okay, temperature of this system is constant, we know that isothermal relation for the gas, PV is equal to RT. That is an equation which you can have for any ideal gas. PV is equal to RT. As I am having, it is an isothermal process, so PV is equal to RT. So it is a constant quantity because T is constant. So what I will get? I will get PV is equal to RT, which is equal to constant, since R is a molar gas constant whose value is 8.31, which is constant, and T is the temperature. Being an isothermal process, this temperature is constant. So product of two constant number, it is a constant. So in the first step, what we will consider, is that the R into T, it is a constant number. So I will get this ratio, PV is equal to constant. So from this equation, I will get PV is equal to constant. So whenever I am having a certain gas, okay, whenever I am having a certain gas, so what I will have? I will have certain amount of volume I am considering over here for this experiment. So let us say the gas or working substance which I have taken for this practical, it is, let us say it is having a volume of 100 meter cube. So here in this case, the volume which we have considered, V1 is equal to 100 meter cube. It is the volume, okay, and the temperature of this gas, what we have considered is that the temperature of this sink in this experiment, we have considered this is at a 500 Kelvin. The temperature for this system we have considered, it is T1 is equal to 500 Kelvin we have considered. So here in this case, I will get the constant. Constant, it is nothing but the R into T. I know the value of R. Value of R is 8.31. Value of R1 is 8.31. Value of the temperature which you have considered in this case, it is a T1, which is the source temperature, because when this cylinder is placed on this source, both these two are in a thermal contact with each other. This cylinder is in thermal contact with the source, so it will have a temperature T1. Okay, this working substance will get a temperature of this source, which is in this experiment I have considered to be 500 Kelvin. If I use a simple calculator for this one, I can calculate this value by using a calculator. If I calculate this value, 8.31 into 500. Okay, so I will get a value of 4155. Okay, or 4155 value I will get over here. So this is my constant for the first experiment. Okay, this is my value for the first experiment. So I'll write it over here. My constant is equal to 4155. The constant which I have calculated, that is 4155. This is the first thing we have to insert. Okay, so in your sheet you have to write 4155. Okay, now this relation. Now in order to calculate the pressure at the different volumes, see, as it is an isothermal expansion, so this piston will move in upward direction. This piston, it will move in upward direction because it is taking a heat from the source. So there will be expansion of the gas. From this relation, PV is equal to RT. Also PV is equal to constant. Now I have calculated the constant, which is 4155. Okay, it is 4155 constant we have calculated, and from this one I can rewrite because I know the volume. Okay, if I write this expression for P, I will get the equation for P as 4155 divided by it is V. Okay, V. Now for different, this is the formula to calculate the values of pressure due to this different volume. Okay, so initially, suppose if I consider the 100 meter cube, so if I divide this number by 100, so it is 4155 divided by 100. So I will get this value around 41.55. So this is my first number, that is 41.55. Okay, this is 41.55. Similarly, if you have the next value, because the gas is expanding, it is an isothermal expansion, so gas will expand. So let us say the volume is increased from 100 to 110. So next pressure you can calculate, that is P is equal to 4155 divided by V. What is the next volume? It is 110. So if you do this calculation, this will be 4155 divided by 110. It will come out to be 37.77. So this number, it will come out to be 37.77. Okay. So this way you can go further. Okay. So last volume for this process, it is 140. So it is 4155 divided by 140. If I calculate 4155 divided by 140, I'll get a number 29.67. Okay. So your gas has expanded from 100 meter cube to 140 meter cube. Okay. So that is the first process. Now what I'll do? Okay. Now this is for the first process. Now for the next process. That is nothing but the adiabatic expansion. So what we will be doing for the adiabatic expansion? Now from this source. Now in the first step, it was this cylinder was placed on the source. Now in this case, what we will do? This cylinder, instead of this source, it will be removed from the source and it will be kept on this insulating stand, because this type of surface, it suggests an insulating surface. So it will be kept on the insulating surface. So due to insulating surface, what will happen? All the edges of this cylinder, it is insulating. So this surface is insulating. So in this case, this working substance or the gas which is inside the cylinder, it is not taking the heat from the surrounding, or it is not giving heat to the surrounding. So what we call such a kind of process, that is nothing but the adiabatic process. Okay, it is an adiabatic process, and this process we are considering, it is over here, it is an adiabatic expansion. Now what happens to the adiabatic expansion? Now see, still it is an expansion. The word suggests that it is adiabatic. It means it is not taking heat from the system, or it is giving heat to the system. Okay. So it is an adiabatic process. Now the pressure of the piston is adjusted such a that. Okay. So the piston will move in upward direction. The external pressure is adjusted such that it will expand in this direction. So your expansion volume, it is going from 150 to 190. Okay. Now we know that being an adiabatic process, the relation between the adiabatic process, it is relation between pressure and volume, it is PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. Here in this case, the working substance or gas we have considered, let us consider that its molar specific heat ratio, which is gamma, it is 2. For this experiment, we are considering gamma to be 2. Okay. So we are taking gamma to be 2. Now see, if I consider these cycles, if I consider the cycles, it will be like this. It will go like this. This is first cycle, which is isothermal expansion. Second cycle, it is adiabatic expansion. The third cycle, it is isothermal compression. And the fourth cycle, it is adiabatic compression. This is third cycle and this is fourth cycle. So if you consider, now let us say when we have started this process, this was C1, it was P1, V1, okay. And now let us say we have reached at the point C2, which is P2, V2. Okay, let us say P2, V2. Now, if I say that this first cycle, it is an isothermal curve. And if I consider this second curve, then it is an adiabatic curve. If you consider this point C2, it is on this isothermal curve as well as the adiabatic curve. So, in order to determine this constant, what I will consider? I'll consider the values which you have obtained for isothermal expansion, which is 140, volume is 140 and the pressure is 29.67. So if I substitute these values, okay, pressure it is 29.67 into volume is 140, okay, to the power gamma, so which is 2, so this is equal to constant. So from this one, I can calculate this constant, and if I use this calculator for this one, so it is 29.67 into 140 square. So this constant, it will come out to be 581532. okay, 581532. This will be the constant. This will be the constant. Okay. So you can note it down, this constant over here. It is, how much is it? It is coming 581532. That is the constant which we have calculated for this adiabatic expansion. Okay. Now this is nothing but the PV raised to gamma, because this constant we have calculated for the adiabatic curve. So this relation will be hold on these points, on these curves. Okay. So I know the values of volume. Okay. I have to calculate the pressure. For this, I can write P is equal to, it will come out to be 581532 divided by V raised to gamma. I'll calculate V raised to gamma. I already know the value of gamma. So it, I'll just substitute in this one. 581532 divided by value of gamma is 2. Value of gamma is 2. So it is V raised to 2. Okay. Or you can write V raised to 2 simply. Okay. Or V square. Okay. So this is the expression which we will be using to calculate the different values of the pressure. Okay. So let us say calculate the first quantity. I know the volume is 150. So 581532 divided by 150 square. So it, because for the first value it is 581532 divided by 150 bracket square. So this if I do, it will come out to be 25.84. This will come out to be 25.84. This, if you do the calculations on the calculator, you will get that value. For the next value, so instead of 150, just I have to make it 160. So the, if I do that, it is 160 bracket square. Okay. So it will be 581532 divided by 160 bracket square. So that will be, that will come out to be 22.71. 22.71. This value will come. If you further go in the in steps of 10, 170, 180, 190, so we will just calculate for the 190, okay. So if I do the calculation for the 190, I'll get the number. You can do the rest of the calculation. It will come out to be 16.10. 108, so it is 16.11. You'll get the value 16.11. That is for this process, okay. So we are done with the adiabatic expansion as well. Now we'll go to the next one. Okay, next cycle. Now for the next cycle, what we will be doing is, for next cycle, what we will be doing is, now instead of this insulating strand, we will be taking this cylinder, we will be putting on the sink. Okay, so third process which will be there. Okay, when it will be placed on the sink, now you can see this is a conducting surface. This is a conducting surface. So whatever it may be the temperature of this one, it will be in direct contact with the sink, which is at the lower temperature T2. So in this process, as it is a thermally in contact with this one, the temperature of this cylinder, it will be maintained at the temperature T2. So in this case, the temperature is constant. So process is isothermal. Okay, isothermal, and the external pressure is adjusted such that the system will go under a compression. The system will go under a compression. Okay, so for isothermal process, we know that PV is equal to RT. That is the relation. And as temperature is constant, R is constant, so this I will be getting PV is equal to constant. So now in order to calculate this constant volume, what we will be taking, we will be taking a value of 190 and 16.11, because that point will be on the adiabatic curve as well as on the isothermal curve. Okay. So let us consider the pressure of 16.11 into volume of 190. Volume of 190, this will give me the constant number. Okay. So this will be the constant. So if I do this calculation into 190, so I'll get this value, and this constant will come out to be 3060.7. okay, this will be the constant. Okay, so here in this case the constant which I will be getting, it is 3060.7, that is a constant. But this constant is nothing but the PV. So from this one I can write PV is equal to 3060.7, but I know the different values of the volume. I need to calculate the pressure, so I'll write down this expression for pressure is equal to, that will be 3060.7 divided by V, and by substituting the different values of this pressure, what I'll do, I'll just be calculating this volume. Okay, so now see, we'll be going from 192, we'll be going from 192, 180, 170, and in this fashion we'll be going back. Okay, so now just consider, for this 180 volume, what will happen to this relation? So it is 3060.7 divided by 180. So this is equal to, okay, if I calculate, okay, so it is 3060.7 divided by 180, I'll get the pressure of 17.00. So this will come out to be 17.00. If I further do the same calculation for the 170, because my volume is decreasing because the gas is compressing, okay, so if I do this for the 170, then I'll get, it is 18, okay, I'll get this value of 18.01. okay, and next if I do this for last value, that is 150, then 3060.7 divided by 150, so I'll get this around 20.40, okay, so this I'll be getting, and we have already calculated this constant for this one, this PV constant we have, which we have derived, it is 3060.7, that is a constant. Okay, and from this expression, from this constant, what we can do is, we can determine the temperature, which is T2, because we know that PV is equal to RT, and the, let us say that temperature is T2. For this, let us say 150 and 20.4. Okay, so it is 150, because PV, that is 150 into 20.40, and if I divide this R on this side, it will be divided, then only I can calculate the temperature, divided by value of R, it is 8.31. So I'll get this temperature, which will come out to be around 368.2 Kelvin. This is the temperature which we'll be getting. Okay, 368.2 Kelvin. Okay, now this is the temperature. So we are done with the third cycle as well. Now we will move to the last cycle. Now with the last cycle, what it has been done, now again from this sink, the cylinder is left, okay, it is left, and it is kept on this insulating stand. So what will happen, as this insulating stand is there, so there will be no exchange of the heat between the system, cylinder and the stand, because it is an insulating surface. Okay, so it is again an adiabatic process. So last number four, that is adiabatic, and the pressure is adjusted such that the system will go under a adiabatic compression. So this will be adiabatic compression, and for adiabatic compression, we know the relation is PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. Okay, PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. For the given working system, gamma is, we have considered 2. So for this one, what we will, in order to calculate this constant, what I will do, I will take 150 and 20.4 as those values. So it is, pressure is 20.4 into volume is 150 raised to 2 is equal to constant. Okay, so from this calculation, we will calculate this constant. So it is 20.4 into 150 bracket square, it will come out to be 45900. Okay, this will be the constant. So we will just note down that constant over there. It is 45900. into 10 to the power 1, 2, 3. So it will be 10 to the power 3. Okay, that will be the constant. Okay, and from this one, so if I substitute this value of constant in this expression, so what I'll get, PV raised to gamma is equal to constant, which is 459000. Okay, so from this one I know the different values of the volume. I have to calculate the pressure. So from this one I can rewrite this expression for P is equal to, I'll write down the value of P is equal to 459000 divided by V raised to gamma. So I have to just take the values of volume. I have to substitute the value of gamma. Value of gamma in this case it is 2 we have considered. Value of gamma we have considered it is 2. So we'll just do the calculation divided by V. Value of V is 140. So 140 square. So it will come out to be 23.41. That is the first value. For the next volume, which is 130, we'll do the calculation. So for 130 it will come out to be 459000 divided by 130 bracket square. So this will come out to be 27.16. If you do the same calculation, if you come up to the 100 volume, so we can do this for the 100. Okay, so 100, if you do this, it will come out to be 45.9. okay, if you divide it by 100 square, it will come out to be 45.9. this will be the final pressure which we'll get. Now see, what we have started is this. We have started with the volume of 100 meter cube. We have expanded the gas up to 190 meter cube. And we have again reached to the 100 meter cube. So we have started with some point. We have went to some point. And we have again reached to the original point. Okay. So it is a complete one cycle. Now we have to draw this graph. Okay. And then we have to interpret what happens to this one. One more important thing is that if you calculate this temperature, you will find out that as the cylinder was kept on the insulating surface and the volume was initially originally again that one, so your body weight will be brought at the original temperature, which will be 500 Kelvin. Okay, so T1 is the temperature of the source which we have considered 500 Kelvin, and T2 is the temperature of the sink which we have considered, we have calculated 368.2 Kelvin. Okay, now we have to calculate the graph of this one. We'll plot the graph of this isothermal and adiabatic curves now. Okay, so in order to calculate or in order to plot the graph of any observation, we have to first of all look into the scales of this one. Now see, your volume is starting. What is the minimum volume? Minimum volume is 100. What is the maximum volume? It is 190. Okay, so in this case, what we will be considering, volume on the x-axis. We will be considering volume V on the x-axis, because that is the variable which we are varying. And the y-axis, what we will be doing, we will be considering the pressure as the another variable. So another variable, it is pressure. So what is the maximum value of the pressure? It is 45.9 or 41.55. Initial pressure is 41.55. Maximum is 45.9. And what is the minimum value of the pressure which we have calculated? It is 60. So maximum is 46. We will consider 45.9. It will be 46. And minimum is 41. Minimum is 16. I will consider. So 46 minus 16. If you do this, you will get 30. So you have to count how many number of lines are there on a vertical axis on your graph paper. Divide that line. Suppose if your graph paper, it is having the 15 lines. Okay, 15 such lines are there. So what you have to take? You have to take two scale means two atmos. Because here in this case, pressure, it is measured in terms of atmosphere. So we have to consider 2 atm. 2 atmospheric pressure is equal to 1 unit. Okay, so what will be our pressure scale? Pressure scale, it will be 2 atmospheric pressure is equal to 1 atm cube. And if you are having a 30 lines on your graph paper, you can consider 31 the 30. So 1 atmosphere is equal to 1 centimeter scale you can consider. Okay, it depends upon your graph paper. Okay, so for convenience, what I'll do, I'll take a scale 1 centimeter on the y axis. This is for y axis. Okay, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 atmosphere. Okay, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 atmosphere I'll take. And on the x axis, what I'll do, see, my maximum volume is 190, my minimum volume is 100. So 190 minus 100, if I do this, I'll get a 90. Okay, so I have to just calculate how many number of lines are there on my graph paper. Okay, and I have to divide by, let us say I have a 18 lines if I have. So I can do this division. If you do this, 90 divided by 18 on calculator, you will get 5. Okay, so you can consider 5 meter cube is equal to 1 centimeter. Okay, so your unit in that case, it will be 1 centimeter is equal to 5 meter cube. Okay, 1 centimeter is equal to 5 meter cube. Or if you don't feel, if there are less than 18 lines, let us say it has a 10 lines. Okay, so if you do this multiple division, it will come out to be 9 meter cube. But it is inconvenient to take 9 meter cube because your volume is increasing in the step of 10. So instead of 9 meter cube as your scale, okay, we will take 10 meter cube as our scale. So our scale now, it has been fixed. 1 centimeter is equal to 1 atm, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 meter cube. So now what I'll do, I'll start on the x axis. My volume is initially 100, so I'll start with the 90. Then it is 100, 110, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90. So it is 100, this will be 110, 120, this will be 140, this will be 150, 160, 170, 180, this will be 190, this will be 190. On the y, or if you wish, you can write down in this middle numbers as well. Okay, so this is 150, this is 170, and so on. Okay, on y axis it is pressure, which is starting from the 16. So let us say we'll start with the 15. Okay, we'll start with the 15, then 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and so on. You can go. Okay, up to how much you have to go? You have to go up to 45. Okay, so if you consider, if I take a 1 centimeter, it is not sufficient. So instead of that, I will take 2 centimeter. Okay, 1 atmosphere is equal to 2 atmospheric pressure. Or for graph paper, I have calculated, it will come out to be 2.5 atm. I will be providing you this sheet. Okay, in which you can take an appropriate scale. Okay, so what we will do, this will be 17.5. This will be 20, this will be 22.5, up like this, you have to go up to 45, okay, you have to go up to 45 or 47.5, okay, 47.5 you can go, 42.5, this will be 40, okay, in between numbers you can put on your graph paper. Now see, on the x-axis there is a volume. What is the initial volume? It is 100. So this is the volume, and how much is the pressure? 41. So 141. So it will come out somewhere over here. Okay, this is your first point. Second point is 110, 37. It will come out to over here somewhere. Okay. So last point, if you calculate 140, 29.67. 140 is here, 29.37. So it will come out over here somewhere. So okay. So it will be like this. So your graph is now like this up to this point. Okay. Now next 150, it will come out to be 25. 150, it will come out to be 25. So it will further go down. So in this fashion, it will go. Then 22, then 16. For 190, it is 16. 190, it is over here. And 16, it will come out to be over here. Okay. So 190, 16, it will go like this. Okay. Your graph will go like this. Your middle, in between points, so it will be like this. Okay. If you plot these points, for all the rest of the calculated values, will get this kind of a graph. Now for the third cycle, it is 180-70. 180-17. 17 is greater than 16. So it will come out to be somewhat in upward fashion. Okay. So now for 170, it is 18. 170, it is further will go upward. Okay. Then for 150, if you calculate, it will come out to be 20. 150, it will come out to be 20. So it will be like this. Okay. In front of 20, in front of 150. Okay. And for 140, it will be now. For this is your, this is C1, this is C2, this is C3. Okay. This is C3. Now, for next 140, 130. 140, it is 23. 140, it is 23. So it will further will go 140, 123. It will further go in upward direction. For 130, it is 27. 130, 27. It will further go, will go up. And for 100, finally, it will come out to be 45. So somewhere over here. So if you calculate this, the graph will, it will look like this. The graph will look like this. Okay. And if you plot the in between points, your graph will look like this one. So last point, it will be, it will go above that point. So, but it will be intersecting. So it is C1, C2, and this is C3. C3 and this is C4. So in this way, this is your P1, V1, which we have said earlier. This is P2, V2. Then this is P3, V3. Okay. And this is P4, V4. This is P4, V4. Okay. Now, this if you consider, if the cycle it is going like this. This is isothermal expansion. This is isothermal expansion first cycle. Then second is, this is adiabatic expansion. Why it is expansion? Because volume is increasing. From this point to this point, your volume is increasing. From this point to this point, volume is increasing. For this one, isothermal compression. You can see from C3 to C4, your curve is going like this. Your curve is going like this. So it is volume is decreasing. So curve is compression. And from this point, it is again compression. Okay. Volume is decreasing. So it is adiabatic compression. Okay. So this way you have to calculate. And we have already calculated the temperature of the source and the sink. So finally, we have to calculate the efficiency of this one. Efficiency of a Carnot engine, it is given by T1 minus T2. It is T1 minus T2 divided by T1. T1 minus T2 divided by T1. So we have considered value of T1. It is 500 Kelvin minus value of T2. We have calculated it is 368.2 divided by value of T1. Value of T1 which was there, it was 500. So we will just do this simple calculation. So 500 minus 368. We will do this calculation. 500 minus 368.2. So it will come out to be 131.8 divided by 500 divided by 500. So it will come out to be 0.2636. Okay. This is efficiency. This is efficiency. Now we will just calculate, convert it into the percentage. So percentage efficiency, if you calculate, just have to multiply this by 100. So it will come out to be 26.36%. Okay. 26.36%. So these curves, isothermal expansion, adiabatic expansion, this is isothermal compression, this is adiabatic compression. Okay. So these are called as first and third is called as the isothermal curve. Second and fourth one is called as the adiabatic curve. We have drawn it on a PV diagram. So it is pressure volume curve. Okay. And we have calculated the efficiency of the Carnot cycle. In the description of the this video, I'll be sending you the sheet of this one, and the calculation which I have performed, I'll share the link with you people. Okay. I hope you have understood this. Okay. In case of any doubts, you can write me. Okay. You can comment as well. We'll stop here for the today's session. Thank you. Thank you so much.